I recently joined a charitable organization and I'm serving as their secretary. This organization has been around for more than 100 years, so taking notes can be a daunting task. There's a lot of background to the discussion. The discussion is wide-ranging, and I need to make sure that the notes I capture will be useful not just to our committee, but to a committee that could be meeting 50 or 100 years from now. So I've been experimenting with some graphic formats to make it easier for me to take notes and also easier for people down the road to see the results of the meeting. So I'll share those with you. The first is a chart format. And so you can see I've got the title at the top and the date of the meeting, who was present, who was not. The agenda items provide the structure for the minutes, as always, and those are in the left column. Then in the central column, I capture the discussion. Note that I do this using bulleted points, which makes it easy for people to see individual members' contributions. I've also used subheadings. This isn't always necessary. If I had just a couple of points for the discussion, I wouldn't break them up with subheadings. But once you start to get a handful or more, it's a good idea to do what we call chunking and labeling and use some subheads. And in the case of the organization I'm working with, one of the subheads is often history because the history is so very long and complex. This is the most important feature of the chart layout, the outcomes column. So here we can very quickly see, even if the discussion goes on for, you know, a page and a half in a long meeting, we have clearly indicated here the motions, so any motions that were passed, as well as actions that are required. So very easy for somebody to skim through this and pick out who was there, what happened at the meeting, and then what was the result. And those are the three big things that you want to take away from any minutes. Now, if this chart layout is either too funky for the crowd that you're working with, or maybe too lengthy because your meetings are very long and your conversations are so complex, then you might try a similar approach using a vertical layout. So here are the same minutes reorganized in a vertical layout. So again, we start with who was there and who wasn't. Here I've actually used a one-row table to create really clear headers. But note that the action points are still bolded. And I've still used subheads here. So this is a tighter organization if you have longer notes, and it also is a format that is still going to be familiar to people you're working with, but maybe a little bit clearer than the traditional narrative format for notes, and also super easy to pick out those action points and keep the action moving for whatever organization you're working with. Hope this is helpful to you this week. If you would like a copy of either or both of these templates, you can direct message me or send me an email, and that's easy to do through my website at www.donhenwood.com.